There was no support question from the Liberated of the Workers.
Right, Honourable Speaker, you could not have been wiser in giving that ruling. In fact, the workers' representatives have ruled
to ensure that the presidential changes, in particular in ministries, are expeditiously implemented. I do expect that this power line is part of those programs that are going to be implemented, and one will get specific details from the minister responsible for energy.
Ulu.
Thank you, Right Honourable Speaker. I would like the Honourable Prime Minister to tell me a minimum wage for our people, because right now, somebody pays. He's not let me say, a baby teacher. 60,000. And 60,000 means it's about $20. And $20 in 1 month, that means then the person has to live below $1 per day. Can you tell the country to know minimum wage so that when I employ a person, I know that I should not pay that person below this value of money? Thank you.
Right, Honourable Speaker, the issue of minimum wage is not a new issue. It has been extensively discussed in the country and in the government, and no consensus has been reached on this matter, and therefore this will wait. The issue of minimum wage will wait until there is a consensus and a final decision taken on the matter. Then the country can be told about this minimum wage.
Thank you, Right Honourable Speaker. Right Honourable Minister, what measures has the government put in place to prevent River Selvik from busting its banks again now that the rain is about to start?
Right Honourable
Speaker, it is true, as my sister has said, that we are still victims of too much rain and too much sunshine. Indeed, we should advance so that we are able to manage excess water. And yes, government has been taking measures, especially in the Missouri area, to control the floods, because we know they are cyclic. And I expect that the minister responsible will be taking some measures to ensure that the population are safe. But I do not have specific details, and I would advise that you interact with the ministry directly responsible. You will get more specific guidance on the matter.
Thank you very much,
Honourable
Speaker. Right Honourable Prime Minister, I'm sure I've read the papers yesterday, in particular the Monitor, and those of us who watched the national television, and we saw the poor youths who were arrested and the manner in which they were arrested. Can the Right Honourable Prime Minister tell this House and the country at large, Right Honourable Minister, you know very well that we fought for the rule of law, human rights and democracy. Can you tell this country the manner in which these people were arrested, whether your government were in standing in the country? Can you tell the country?
Right Honourable
Minister.
Right Honourable Minister.
under the advice of the law-abiding and the peaceful. Contravention of the law has consequences. Therefore, to avoid the consequences, I advise the people of Uganda to be as law-abiding, as peaceful as possible. Secondly, yes, the law enforcement agencies should indeed enforce the law in accordance with laws of the land. They should not go beyond what the law prescribes.
Amuro District, you are aware that for 4 successive years, the staff establishments in public universities is really stagnant at about 30%, and that is leaving 70% shortfall, and that has very serious implications in the quality and effectiveness in teaching and research at our public universities. What is your government going to do in the coming year to really improve on this? And not only that, we know that those who are doing also part-time in these public universities, part-time lecturers and visitings, are hardly paid. They go without salaries and without the remuneration, and they leave out teaching in universities.
Right.
Mr. Speaker, sir, public universities are very important institutions where most of us have gone through, and government will do everything possible to give support to these universities. The question of 30% being currently employed compared to the overall structure of staff requirements, this is a figure that is rather surprising to me. Nevertheless, it will be looked at, and I know that government through whatever it can support and continue supporting these institutions. The question of non-payment to people who are doing part-time, I think the laws of the land are clear. If you contract somebody to do a piece of work for a certain amount of money, you have an obligation according to the laws of the land to pay. Therefore, the employers should definitely, in accordance to the laws of the land, pay their employees.
Cover the municipality.
We cannot ignore that. Not only has Stephen Mateke given us a very powerful daughter to serve in the house, but he has come himself at this stage to make sure that he has value to the front bench, which has constantly disappointed us by remaining empty. Right, Honourable Speaker, I want to appreciate the diplomatic manner in which the Prime Minister answers questions. I must appreciate that. And I believe that the Right Honourable Speaker, it is high time the Prime Minister increasingly becomes more concerned about practical matters and decreasingly moves away from diplomacy. The creation of new districts, for those of you who have been following political history in this country, the creation of new districts has been a menace, and it normally comes at a time when the elections are just a few months away. And we want the Prime Minister to tell us that it will never happen again, so that we can now agree as a country that can all counties become districts, so that we know that this year we are going to budget for so many districts, next year we will budget for, so that there is no predictability.
Honourable Member, just on that.
Yeah.
On the notice of business to follow, we have an item 15, which is a motion for presentation. So don't preempt
I think I'm just advising so that when they come to talk, they should know how to deal with it. I think the predictability is absolutely important, right, Honorable Prime Minister. I went to Northern Uganda, including my district, allegedly distributing articles for war-affected persons. And this is directly from the office of the Prime Minister. And selectively,
I've tried to be respecting the but that's not what the rules say. That's not what the rules say. The rules, first of all, you don't have a right of reply because it's not yours.
Yes.
The person with the right of reply is the Prime Minister. You are supposed to summarize those issues and propose policy matter on those that have been captured briefly. It's not supposed to be a complete reply to the State of the Nation address.
Right, Honorable Speaker, you know, the biggest problem I have is that I come from a rural area. Was brought up with a village environment.
That one so, is that one is not about the back of now.
Yeah, so so forgive me if I digress a bit. But the issue of policy I'm raising here is that if the war affected persons are being compensated, can we know what are the mechanisms the Prime Minister's office is using to select those war affected persons?